Let's determine the following limits graphically. First, we have the limit as x approaches positive 2 from the negative or left side of f of x. So this notation here means we have a one-sided limit. We're approaching 2 only from the left side. Looking at the second limit, we have the limit as x approaches positive 2 from the positive side or right side of the function f of x. So let's go ahead and draw a vertical line at x equals 2 so we can see exactly where we're approaching. So we're approaching this vertical line here. So for this first one-sided limit, we're approaching from the negative side or left side of positive 2. So we're approaching positive 2 along the function here. And then for the second limit, we're approaching positive 2 from the right side or positive side along here. So for this first limit, the left-sided limit, notice as we get closer and closer to positive 2, the function goes down without bound. When we talk about a function value, we're talking about a y value. So we can see these y values are going down forever. Therefore, they're approaching negative infinity. So for this left-sided limit, it's equal to negative infinity, which does not exist. And then as we approach positive 2 from the right side, notice how the function increases without bound. Therefore, the y values increase without bound and approach positive infinity. So the right side of the limit is equal to positive infinity, which again does not exist. Now these last two limits are just regular limits, so we'll be approaching the given value of x from both sides. So for the limit as x approaches 2 of f of x, as we approach positive 2 from both sides, which we did separately in these one-sided limits, and notice how one's approaching negative infinity, the other is approaching positive infinity, and therefore we know this limit will not exist. Not only are they not approaching the same value, neither of them exist. So for the limit as x approaches 1 of f of x, let's go ahead and clear our work here and draw a vertical line at x equals positive 1. And notice how it's going to pass right through this hole in the graph, but a hole in the graph is not going to affect whether the limit exists or not, because we're not concerned about what the function value is equal to when x is equal to 1. We're concerned about what it's approaching as we approach positive 1 from both the left side and the right side. So even though there's a hole right here at x equals 1, we're approaching this point here, and therefore we're approaching the function value or y value of negative 1. So the limit as x approaches 1 of f of x is equal to negative 1. In the last video on determining limits graphically, we'll take a look at limits at positive and negative infinity.